Hello, Medford community. I'm Brett Champion, the proud superintendent of schools here in the Medford School District. And welcome to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. We are so grateful to our partners who helped us bring Medford Anywhere Learning TV to life. And those include Southern Oregon PBS, KTVL, KDRV, and the Dove TV. Special shout out to Southern Oregon PBS for also producing these parts. In the Medford School District, we believe that all are learning, and learning is for all. And what better venue to share our learning than Medford Anywhere Learning TV? Welcome.
Hello, Student Reporting Lab students. Welcome to Shifting the Frame, Student Reporting Lab's lesson number one. My name is Ben Garcia. I work for SO PBS, that's Southern Oregon PBS. I co-teach a couple Student Reporting Lab's classes here in the Medford School District. And today we're going to undertake this lesson plan together in a virtual telecourse format. Our essential question for the day is, what is the difference between a topic, an issue, and an event, specifically relating to news, a news topic, a news issue, a news event. And our learning target is, I can define and understand foundational vocabulary relating to journalism. So as you've probably already figured out, these terms relate to not only the news, but the art of journalism. Today's activities, in a nutshell, will consist of, we're gonna start our lesson plan by having a conversation with my co-teacher, Ivan Olinghouse, relating to what are issues and what are topics and what are events. We're gonna go over a few of those and talk about their differences and similarities. And then together, we'll do an activity where we write topics and issues that are most important to us on a sticky note, and we create like a handout, and then we'll create a class board, which represents our three topics and issues that are most important to us. And then we'll try to narrow down what our one most important issue and topic is for each of us. And then class will be over with. You'll have an exit pass activity. And since you're doing this from home, it will be like a fun assignment that you can do with friends or family. So let's get this started with our first discussion. As I mentioned earlier, my teaching partner, Ivan Olinghouse, was going to help us out with this next activity. Ivan, would you like to tell students a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, absolutely. My name is Ivan Olinghouse. I'm a teacher here at Hedrick Middle School. I teach a lot of different electives, but one of the courses I teach is the Student Reporting Labs that we have here. We have a video production class, and that's what this lesson plan goes along with.
Absolutely. And so as we're trying to understand the difference between these vocabulary terms, issues, events, and topics, Ivan's going to be a thought partner in this process. So Ivan, to the best of your knowledge and ability, can you define in your own words what a news topic is, a news issue is, and a news event?
Sure. So an event, a topic, an issue, I kind of think of them in this order. I'll go news topic, and then I'll go news issue, and then I'll go news event. The topics, if we think about this like an umbrella, the topic is that overarching part of the umbrella. And that could be anything that is, let's say like sports is a topic in our American media, in any media across the world, as is, say, human health. Health and sciences would be like a topic. We could have economics, we could have government, politics. Those are all these big topics. And then underneath those topics, we could have issues that are specific to a topic. So let's take underneath that topic of sports, we could say something like, a major issue right now is the closure of all sporting events across the world. So all sporting events are being closed up right now. This is a major issue because it's stopping all sports, all the way from professional leagues, all the way down to little leagues and the children's sports and youth sports. Now, underneath that issue, we could have specific events. So here in Oregon, for example, the Portland Trail Blazers season was suspended indefinitely a few weeks ago, right before school got out. And that is that that moment in time, that event that happened that we have articles written about, that particular event.
Okay. So if sports is our topic, and our issue is the cancellation of sporting events, then the basketball game that I was planning to go to 3 weeks ago was canceled. And so that particular, if there was an article written about that particular event that was canceled, then that would classify as both a news issue and also a news event.
Yeah, and it's underneath this overall topic of sports as well.
Okay, so considering what we're going through right now, the COVID-19 outbreak, would COVID-19 be a news topic, a news issue, or a news event?
Sure, let's break it down. So if we have a topic in this case, we have the topic of sciences and human health. Let's say that's the topic that we're working under when we're discussing COVID-19. Now, the issue is the outbreak across the world of COVID-19, the COVID-19's effect on humans and on our society and what it does to our economic systems in addition to our health. That those are issues. Now, the actual events of COVID-19, for example, is our daily event updates on the number of outbreak cases that we have. How many new cases do we get today? Well, that's a specific news event within the issue of the COVID-19 virus, within the topic of human health and sciences.
So our governor recently announced a order which is instructing citizens of Oregon to stay home and stay healthy. She had a news conference where she made that announcement. So that news conference was written about in many articles. That conference itself was an event, right?
Yes.
The governor's address to the state. And then the order that was mandated, stay home, stay healthy, that is an issue that was also written about.
Now, the order itself is an event. The moment where she wrote the order, and that's that news story of, oh, here's this order that's been dropped. Now, the issue, though, is that people have been canceled in their daily activities outside of their homes.
Right, lots of issues.
Stay at home, staying at home, that's an issue. What do you do? How do we accomplish this? How does the state enforce the rules? All these things are issues within that.
So, for example, Mr. O and I were walking into the school this morning, and there were some citizens using the track as they're normally allowed to do, but there's a sign now on the fence that says, due to Governor Kate Brown's order, this public park will be closed down. Mm-hmm. So that is an issue relating to the recent event of the order, which are all underneath this big topic, sprawling topic of pandemics.
I do want to clarify one thing though, that the event is the person who's running around the track when they shouldn't be. That's a specific event. It's a result of the issue of the fact that we should be staying at home. That event occurred because of the issue.
So then if one of our student journalists were to interview that citizen, they would talk about the event, and they'd also talk about the issue. So it'd be both an issue and an event. And
yeah, the event happens within inside the issue, right? So the event is a moment in time, a capture of what's details that are happening within this particular issue.
Okay, so let's go back up to pandemics. We know that that is a topic, and then COVID-19 is a type of pandemic. How soon does COVID-19, because of all the stories being written about it, all the events and issues, how soon does it become a topic? Would you say that it's already become a topic?
Yeah, I think it is at this point, yeah, because this is, once it became a pandemic, that release of it becoming a pandemic, that it has become a historical event, that it's something that's reached a magnitude to where it is its own conversational topic. 40 years from now, we'll be able to talk about the event of COVID-19 with the issues that are relating to it. And it's all because the world as a whole will be aware of the topic.
Okay. So let's try to understand this better by looking at a slide which has lots of issues, events.
Yeah. And it's been hanging out here in the background in the meantime.
If we look at this slide here, we have in the upper left-hand corner topics in blue. We have issues in pink or purple, depending on how it appears on your screen. On my laptop, issues is purple, but on our studio TV, it's pink. So just whenever I talk about pink or purple, just associate those colors with issues. And then events are greens. So if we look at the left-hand column, we have topics. And in the middle of that column, we have climate change. The word climate is blue, change is pink or purple. So we know that this phrase, climate change, is both a topic and it's also an issue. How is climate change both an issue and a topic?
Yeah, so in this case, if we're talking about the global climate, we have a topic, right? But if we're talking about climate change, we're talking about something that's happening to the topic. Something's going on inside of it, and that's where we get the issue from. That something is changing about our topic. In this case, thus we have an issue that's going to be occurring.
Okay. So when Mr. Olinghouse and I were growing up in the 80s, climate change was not a phrase that was a part of our like common popular vocabulary.
Not yet.
And so back then in the 80s, there were scientists that were studying it. In dusty office spaces in universities across the nation.
Perhaps, yes.
And so at that time, it wasn't yet a topic. It was just an issue that was being researched. But then, as we started to talk more about it in the media, and politicians started talking about it more and more, and we started seeing huge environmental changes in our climate, then we started talking more about it. And then there were documentaries made, like Al Gore's famous documentary, An Inconvenient Truth. And it became talked about so much that it eventually became a topic. And I immediately think about this very common phrase, topic of conversation. So if something has become so common that it can be a topic of conversation, then maybe it's elevated to topic status, like sports or business. So now let's take a look at the issue side of the slide. We have war in Afghanistan. War is in green. Afghanistan is in pink or purple, depending on how you're viewing it. And so we know that the war in Afghanistan is an event. And we know that that Afghanistan has lots of issues related to it.
Yeah, so if you're talking about an entire country, you could say that when we're talking about topics, we could have sports, but you could also have North American sports. In this case, we're talking about war in Afghanistan. That is a particular event, but there are lots of issues relating to that. And it's been protracted over 19 years now to where I think it has raised itself to its own topic level as the longest running war in American history.
So then war in Afghanistan could be a topic. We know for sure it's an issue because it's been discussed a lot.
Definitely an issue.
And it's also an event. It's a long event that has unfolded over decades. So we could also put a blue underline underneath that entire phrase, war in Afghanistan, because it is both, it is all three. It is topic, an issue, and an event. So that might still be difficult for our viewers to understand. Sure. So why don't you pick one?
Yeah, absolutely. Let me just clarify with a little bit with the topic.
Okay.
War in Afghanistan is not necessarily referring just to the one war that we're currently engaged in.
Right.
War in Afghanistan is a topic unto itself because there has been a series of wars in Afghanistan over the years, and we can trace back through history. It is an entire subject matter. That I think that's where it gets that topical status from.
Right.
Not just necessarily from the one war.
And we know that the country itself can be a topic. If you were to look up Afghanistan in the encyclopedia, you would find out all kinds of information about the country, all kinds of topical information about the country. Its topography, its economy, etc. So topics are very big ideas. Yeah. Issues are medium-sized ideas. Events are maybe medium-sized to a little bit smaller, but that's kind of the hierarchy we're looking at. Topic, issue, and event. All right, let's do a quick review. When I was researching the differences between topics and issues, I found this great article online which talked about the easiest way to understand the difference between the two are if you look at your average newspaper. So let's take a look at a newspaper. Here's the front of the newspaper, and inside of the newspaper, there are all these sections. So for example, here is a section that says Nation and World. Nation and World is the topic. And then in this section, we know we're going to have lots of articles that have issues that relate to our nation, the United States, and the world at large. So let's take a quick look. Here it says, government plans to ban vaping flavors. So we know that vaping is a huge health issue as of the last few years. In our nation, in the United States. And so that would be an issue that would fall under nation for this particular type of issue as it relates to the government planning or banning things. So let's look at another section. We have the opinion section. And if we look here, it says, deaths show vaping is not safe. So again, we have another issue of vaping. And we have an editorial, which is someone that works for the newspaper. They're writing their opinion about vaping, and then they ask for your view. And then we have letters to the editor here, which express different people's views. And let's take a look at another section. We have health. So we know that health is a big topic. And here it says Italy sets more specific rules. And if you read the article, rules relating to COVID-19 lockdown or shelter or stay home, stay safe rules and regulations. So again, we have the issue of government rules and regulations relating to COVID-19, and that is, and those are issues that fall underneath the broad topic of health. Let's take a look at another section of the paper. Here we have sports. Sports, a big, broad topic with lots of issues that fall underneath sports. So we have the Tokyo Games maybe postponed. That relates to the Olympics, and the Olympics fall underneath sports. So we have big topic, we have a topic that's almost just as big, the Olympics, and then we have the issue of the games being postponed because of the outbreak. And then lastly, we have in our newspaper, we have a section here, local and state. And then we have an issue here of botanicals being approved for Ashland pot delivery. That is a hot topic issue here in Oregon, because as we all know, marijuana has been legalized for legal use for adults. And there's been lots of issues since its legalization a few years ago relating to it. That is in the local and state. That falls underneath the local state topic. It could also fall underneath health as well. So just keep that in mind. A lot of these issues could also fall underneath other topics as well.
All right, so for the next part of our project, we are going to be building a My SRL poster. Let me show you a little bit of what we're looking for. We're going to be building a poster that has 8 different topics on it, 4 on the front, 4 on the back. We're going to write our topics in, like you see the little picture there on the left that says natural disasters. You'll just write a big old topic right there. And then on the stickety note on the right, what we're going to do is write an I wish statement. We want something along the lines of, I wish people knew. So it's how do we want something about our topic to be thought of differently? What is it that we'd like to change about how that topic is viewed? And that's one of the powers that we have in journalism. So as we go into here, we're going to look at this little poster board. I've already got a few built here for you. I'll show you what they look like. We have mental health with an I wish statement, poverty, music, nutrition. And then on the back side of this, I'm starting on my second group. I've got one here that says dress code. So for the I wish statement under here, I wrote, I wish people knew that dress codes impact girls more than boys. This is something I hear all the time from my middle school students. All right, let me go ahead and I'll show you how to create another one. I'll show you on camera here. Okay, for my next topic, I'm going to be writing about animal adoption. It's going to be my topic. So I'll write big letters here, animal adoption. This is something that I feel passionate about. You'll have to pardon my sloppy writing. So for animal adoption, I'm now going to write underneath it, I'm going to write an I wish people knew statement. So here I wrote, I wish people knew how many pets need a home. And at this point, I would go ahead and write 2 more of these topics as well. This is something for you to do as well, and hopefully whoever you're working with as well, you want them to be doing this in addition. So this activity is quite important, as finding the things that we're passionate about, the things that we want to change in the world, the things that we would like to see become important to us, this is our way of bringing those things into focus, as well as all of these little activities that we're doing now are going to be connecting to activities that we will be doing later in the curriculum as well.
Now to the next part of our activity, where you will create an Our SRL class poster, and you will use your My SRL handouts and the handout of a friend or a family member, where you will essentially be taking your top 3 from your 8, because we know that you have 8, your top 3, and you will post your top 3 topics, not the statements, just the topics, on this Our SRL class, so you can gain a deeper understanding of what topics are most important to your class. how this would work out in a class setting with more students would be student volunteers would share some topics and issues and some I wish people knew statements, and Mr. Olinghouse and I will do that today. Students will write three of their topics and issues on the top three new post-it notes, the three most important to them, and stick them on the My SRL class poster. Now, the reason why you're writing three new ones is so that you can keep the old ones for your My SRL handout, and we'll use that handout later on in the school year for another activity. And then you'll have a class conversation relating to this question: what do you notice about the diverse interests in issues and topics on the My SRL class poster? So Mr. Olinghouse and I are gonna do this right now.
Yeah.
All right. So do you wanna start, Mr. Olinghouse?
Yeah, absolutely. So I threw out four. I have music, nutrition, poverty, and mental health as my important topics. For these, one that is I'm probably going to pull out of this is music. I'm not going to use this one right now, though it is dear to my heart. I said, I wish more music was present in elementary levels. I mean, like, I wish we had more music in elementary school, like when we're little kids and stuff like that. I think that'd be really awesome. But the real big hitters for me is mental health. This one, I wish more people understood how their behaviors affect mental health. That's a big one for me. How about for you, Mr. Garcia?
Sure. Like you, on the front page here, I'm not going to include one of these four, and I'm not going to include celebrities, but I wanted to point out my I wish statement for celebrities. I wish people knew that Bill Nye, the science guy, is still a celebrity. Students still know him. So celebrities are more than just movie stars and musicians, and I love that idea.
Yeah.
And I love that kids are still into Bill Nye the Science Guy. But the first of my three is probably gonna be education, because I wish people knew, especially in Southern Oregon, knew more about Student Reporting Labs, which is this amazing class that Mr. O and I teach together.
Yeah, the next one for me is definitely gonna be nutrition. For me, nutrition, I wish nutrition was a more talked about subject in our community. This is something that's really important in terms of the health of our families, our students. It's important for everyone. Nutrition's a big one for me.
And then next for me is pandemics, and that's because of what's going on right now. I wish people knew that COVID-19 is not like the flu in many ways, especially relating to its morbidity and mortality rates, which are markedly higher. Without policies like social distancing and work from home, et cetera, we would not be able to get a leg up on this current pandemic. And so this is important.
All right, my next one is gonna be poverty. I wish we had more resources to address poverty. And I'm always grateful for people who work in this area and help others out. But in this case, this is an issue that if I could control our news, I wish we could focus on this a little more.
Okay. And for me, the arts. I lived through a tough time in education where arts education programs were being cut. And so I wish people knew that arts education is just as important as science is for the health of our community and democracy. So, as you just saw, Mr. Olinghouse and I just had a conversation about our topics and why we chose them. So do not forget to have this conversation about why these topics and issues are important to you and the family member that you're doing this exercise with.
Okay, now for the last part of our activity. What you do is you choose your one topic or issue that is most important to you, and you stick it to your class's What's in the Frame poster, and mine is pandemics because of what is going on right now. And then you take your I wish people knew statement relating to that topic and put it on your class's I wish people knew poster, and then have a quick discussion.
Yeah. So what'd you pick for yours? You chose pandemics, yep. And the reason was more people knew about the details of it.
I absolutely wish people knew more about the details. I was in the grocery store the other day, and there were people in the grocery line that were not exercising social distancing, and they were having a conversation about how this pandemic might not kill as many people as flu does.
That's tough.
I had to talk to them, engage them in a conversation about how it actually does kill a lot more people than the flu does.
While keeping social distancing. Better than we are right now.
Yes. In a studio, it's a little bit more difficult. So,
for mine, I chose mental health. That's by far my most important one. On here, I'll throw it up here. Mental health. And I'm going to put my statement, I wish more people understood how behaviors affect mental health.
Can you tell us a little bit more about your I wish statement? Like, what kind of understanding about what kind of behaviors?
Yeah, absolutely. I wish we knew how our own behaviors could affect mental health, but not just ours, but the how our behaviors affect people around us as well. We want to be careful about that. Because you never know how somebody else might be interpreting your actions.
Okay, for our last wrap-up activity, which you don't have to do right now, you can do later, on a piece of paper or in your notepad or notebook, write a response to the following prompt. If you could change how your most newsworthy topic is talked about by others, how would you cover it? Like if you had control over every newsroom in the world and how they covered this story. You should take your time and think about this, and also think about keeping a notepad or a notebook with you at all times, because any good journalist is constantly writing about issues and topics that they're encountering in their day-to-day life. There is an example below which you can read and consider on your own time, and do not forget to share your response with your parent or family member at home or friend that you're undertaking this activity with. Thanks and have a good day.
Thank you for joining us today on Medford Anywhere Learning TV for the latest updates on what's going on in the Medford School District, including COVID-19 updates, as well as next steps for Medford Anywhere Learning, because there's always more still to come. Check out our website at www.medford.k12.or.us. See you soon.